Excuse me for doing this. As father of the bride, I'd like to welcome you all, and myself, Robert and Joanna, to this wonderful, amazing venue that we've got the wedding at today. This room here in the chapter house is 800 years old, and there's been some amazing history here. The monks used to read scriptures here, which is where the name came from. And you're all adding to that history today. So, you know, just enjoy the day because we've got such a wonderful place to be. I've just got to mention that two people who can't be here tonight, unfortunately, or today, Jenny's grandpa Alan and Ed's grandma Nelly, who are both not well enough to attend, unfortunately. So it's a bit sad, but they can't be here today. One of our most famous entrepreneurs, Richard Branson, once said, "A speech should be like a woman's skirt, long enough to cover the subject, but short enough to keep your interest." So, I hope I've got this right. It's Jenny's father. That's her. I've always thought that Jenny was gorgeous, but you've got to say she looks absolutely stunning. Jenny is a successful teacher, in part because she has an inquiring mind and is not embarrassed to be open about the things she does not understand, which primary school children seem to find fascinating. As her father, there have been times when I've felt we have a similar teacher-pupil relationship. For example, I've had questions of Jenny, such as what the hoverflies do on the day off. Does anybody know? I couldn't answer that one. What the hoverflies do on the day off? When I was teaching her to drive, which way is left? Why do submarines have to go underwater? Why can't they just stay on the surface? I don't know. Not long ago, I had a phone call of Jenny asking me if I could explain the interaction between the Earth and the Moon, and how good we got day and night, because she was going to teach this to the children the next day. I said to her, "Well, how long have you got?" She said, 10 minutes, make it quick. I'd just like to say a word about Edward. Not only is Edward my son-in-law, but he's a good mate. As most of you probably know, we've got season tickets at Chester Football Club. And when Ed asked me if he could marry Jenny, he did it at the blues bar while we had a pint before a home game. You can't say no, can you, really? Today, Ed, you've got, for the first time in your life, you have a mother-in-law. I've got a mother-in-law, and I've had one for 38 years. You're amazed what they can get up to. For example, when Jenny was very young, Irene, my mother-in-law, came to stay, and she got one of our neighbours, Tim here, to help her dig a tree up in our front garden because she thought it was dead. We didn't know anything about it. The tree just got dug up while we're out. This is you, this.
It was dead. It definitely was dead.
The tree didn't even say anything. Anyway, I think it's time in this garden. You've got yet to find out what Jackie's is. So good luck with that. Welcome to the family, Ed. It's lovely to see so many friends of Jenny's here today from primary school, including Becky, wherever Becky is. Becky taught Jenny, Becky down there. Becky taught Jenny from a little toddler, then worked with her, was her mentor and colleague at school. Thanks very much for that, Becky. We've also got a lot of high school friends here and housemates from Jen's time at university. All have been a huge part of Jen's life and ours as well. Thanks must go today to one of those friends, Jenny Cross. Where's Jenny? Jenny Cross. Jenny was at our house today, crack of dawn, doing the hair for Jenny and the bridesmaids. Never seen so many curlers in my life. You want to see the size of these things, the potted hair. You know, the house full of curlers, but it all worked. You wouldn't have thought she looked like that and see her at 7 months. One final thought, not long after Jenny and Ed started going out together, which was about 6 years ago, Grand Judith. Where's Grand Judith?
Yeah.
Grand Judith? Yeah. So to Grand Irene, for the first time they met at Abbeygate College concert, Judith said to Irene, they can get married in the cathedral. They'd only be going out 5 minutes. And she was right. Jenny and Ed have named each table today after song titles, which I think is great. But I've got one for Ed. 1961 hit song by Bobby V called Don't You Care My Name. We are so proud of Jen for all the fun, laughter and love she brings to us and the whole family. And finally, I would like to raise a toast to the bride and groom and wish them all the best. Thank you.